This past week, two of my favorite websites reached out to me and said, hey, you gotta change your password. There's this scary thing called a reused password attack. It's a thing where hackers steal passwords from all over the internet and then use those passwords to log into your favorite sites to steal your accounts. This happens every single year. And 97.25% of the time, I mean, that's like not a real statistic, but a lot of the time, it's due to this one nasty, dirty little trick. The oldest trick in the book. Welcome to Comp Chomp, the only show on the internets where digital trypanophobia is a thing. You can look it up. I mean, we did. You and your BFFs get together to crank out your next multi-million dollar app. It's a restaurant finder for dragon lovers, of course. You build a snazzy login page full of all sorts of dragony delights. Then, you realize that when someone logs in, you have to have somewhere to store that data. You're gonna need a database. Think of a database like a bank vault that can hold all sorts of information. From the mundane, like SexyCoder5 has logged in 47 times, to the embarrassing, like the fact that my username is SexyCoder5, to the private, like my social security number, 093. I'm definitely not gonna give that to you guys that easily. But you get the idea. Structured query language, SQL to its friends, is a language used to talk to that database. If you want to torture that bank metaphor just a tiny bit more, SQL would be a simplistic bank teller. As long as you fill out that bank slip correctly, information flows in and out of that bank vault, no questions asked. And that setup works fantastic, as long as your app is never going to be touched by a stranger. And we definitely want strangers to interact with our app, because Eats for Dragon Lovers is not going to be successful if my mom is the only one using it. Especially if my mom gives it a 1-star rating. You haven't called in 3 days? Not legitimate criticism, Mom, but thanks. So we put up web forms and we ask people for their username, their password, their date of birth. We have checkboxes. Do you accept these agreements? We put comment boxes down below that we ask you to fill out. And all of this is done so that strangers can interact with our app. So you take the information that strangers enter into those forms and you send it directly to your database. And for the most part, this works fine because most people want your app to work the way they expect it to. And then one day, this Shady McShadester hears about your app on TechCrunch. Dragon Eats, it's the Uber for the Yelp of the Dragon World. Or something like that. And he logs in and he searches for this restaurant. Yeah, don't worry. We'll wait while you type it in. Tasty. And the second he presses enter, we take what he searched for and it turns into this SQL query. Select restaurant.star from restaurants where name like blank, delete from restaurants %. And like that, your entire restaurant table is gone. Not the table you had at the restaurant, but you should definitely cancel those reservations because you get to spend the rest of the evening restoring your database from backups. Yay! It's fun. Done it. This nasty little trick, it's known as SQL injection. It's where Shady McShadester closes out a legitimate transaction with your database and then quickly shoves some more queries in there so that he can interact with your data in a way you absolutely did not intend. Thousands of sites are affected every single year. But I mean, come on, these gotta be those like little 1-in-2-man shows that were built by your neighbor's best friend's girlfriend's dog groomer's cousin who kinda knows how to code, right? I mean, you'd think so, but no. In 2011, Sony was the victim of multiple SQL injection attacks. Multiple, including one where hackers stole over 1 million username and password combinations, and the passwords are stored in plain text. In 2012, the personal records of thousands of university students were SQLed right into the waiting hands of people who like to steal their credit records because they're so pristine. I guess that's one positive side effect of crushing student loan debt. No one's gonna steal your identity anymore. The hackers over in Russia, they didn't just want to steal millions of records at a time. They used a combination of a botnet and SQL injection to steal 1.2 billion, with a B, username and password combinations from over 400,000 websites. And a lot of those websites were Fortune 500 company websites. Come on, guys. The real tragedy here? This is so easy to avoid! Look, you can't keep Shady from using your app. But what you can do is make sure that none of the stuff he ever puts in the form goes directly to your database. You gotta sanitize it first. and you sanitize it by making sure that every single character that means something to SQL is ignored, so that his info is treated as nothing more than a string.
A harmless little string. A little string like this guy.
This isn't a string. Imagine. Imagination. You should also use prepared statements. Before a single bit of user information goes to your database, you send that query in with placeholders. It decides what kind of actions it'll take. Then later, when user information comes in, it won't veer from that path. So Shady McShadester can shove all of the SQL he wants into that form, and your data is safe.
Safe!
Totally safe. It's a little extra work, but a small price to pay to keep your app out of the news for all the wrong reasons. The last thing that you want is for your Twitter to be blowing up because Dragon Restaurant Chima call it got hacked, and now some anonymous IP in Russia is threatening to put your username and passwords all over the internet. You gotta sanitize that. Chomp!